On the subject of movies, ignore the twit who told you that The Rookie is at 10:05 tomorrow night. It's at 9:05. Now, news.
From the studios of ITN, the news with Dennis Toohey.
Hello, welcome to the programme. The headlines tonight. Speculation grows over scandal MP's future. The last video, a cult's chilling farewell. And Ince is back as England skipper. The Conservatives are under double pressure tonight in the sex and sleaze controversies. In the first, there's growing speculation that Piers Merchant, the MP who denies an affair, will be forced to go before the end of the bank holiday weekend. In the second, Labour is standing down its candidate in Neil Hamilton's constituency to make way for what it hopes will be an anti-corruption candidate. Our political correspondent Tom Bradby reports.
Tonight there is still no sign of Mr. Merchant. He disappeared last night with the help of neighbours and hasn't returned. The Tory hierarchy are keeping up the pressure.
This is a matter for him and his family and the association to discuss and to debate and to resolve. They have access to all of the information, and I'm sure they will, in their own time, come to an appropriate decision.
But some of Mr. Merchant's local party officials seem to be in a rebellious mood and are sending a clear message to the leadership.
Oh, well, they'll have to just wait until we've made our minds up. I mean, why should they interfere? Whenever we ask them to do something, they never do it as quickly as we wanted to do it. They will now realise how difficult they make life for us.
So what is your message at this point to Mr. Mulwinnie?
Wait and see.
The Liberal Democrats said they did not want to comment, believing this was a matter for Mr. Merchant and his family. But Labour referred back to the controversy over cash for questions.
There is no innocent until proven guilty regarding these allegations as far as the leadership of the Conservative Party is concerned. And yet they still continue to defend their colleagues.
And tonight, Labour said their candidate in Neil Hamilton's constituency will stand down in favour of a joint anti-sleaze candidate. The Liberal Democrats said they would consider it.
Tonight, the Tories have dismissed the attack on Neil Hamilton as a pathetic gimmick. But there's no doubt they are extremely annoyed with Mr. Merchant. They think he's been very foolish and should resign soon, preferably this weekend. Tom Bradby, ITN, at Conservative Central Office.
More details emerged today of the mass suicide by 39 cult members in California. They left a chilling farewell message on video after their leader told them they'd be reincarnated on a spaceship. From California, James Mates reports.
The police know who they are, they know how they killed themselves, but piecing together what exactly drove 39 healthy men and women to take their own lives is taking longer. The arrival of the comet Hale-Bopp in the night skies above Southern California appears, though, to have been the signal for the cult's leader, Marshall Applewhite, to order the suicides.
We don't believe that our Father's kingdom has much need for these flesh bodies, but it's possible that a spacecraft will come down and we'll walk on board that craft and they'll take these bodies from us.
In a farewell video, the cult members tried to explain their motives.
If people would just know that we're not forced into this in any way, it's, you know, our own choosing to do it, and I'm really happy that I made this choice.
I just want to say how thankful I am to Doe and T for helping me and taking me under their wing and showing me the ways of the next level, and all my classmates have been so great to me and all the problems I've caused.
It's not something that somebody brainwashed me into or convinced me of or did a con job on. Something I have grown to know and to understand.
Their leader, Applewhite, dressed his followers in black before giving this final chilling message.
Let me say that our mission here at this time is about to come to a close.
Almost all the bodies were found covered in purple shrouds, each wearing identical new black training shoes. Police believe two of the 39 had stayed behind to arrange the bodies before taking their own lives. In one cupboard were supplies of the drug phenobarbital, which, when mixed with vodka, proved lethal. Nearby were written instructions on how it should be done.
Put the medicine in and stir it, and then eat it quickly, drink this vodka mixture, which they apparently had mixed up, and then lay back and rest quietly.
There is no suggestion that any of the 39 did not go to their deaths entirely voluntarily. The suicides were so meticulous, so carefully planned, but those involved clearly believed they were simply moving on. James Mates, ITN, San Diego, California.
Israeli troops opened fire again today on hundreds of Palestinian protesters. It came as a special envoy sent by President Clinton ended his two-day mission to try to put the peace process back on track. From Israel, Tim Hewitt reports.
There was talk of peace, but no evidence of it today. As President Clinton's special envoy tried to bring the two sides together, they seemed as far apart as ever. U.S. negotiator Dennis Ross, arriving from talks with Palestinian leader Yasser Arafat, sat down with Israel's Prime Minister Netanyahu. The Israelis are still demanding assurances on an end to terrorism.
We want to see clear, concrete actions on the part of the Palestinian Authority to curb this terrorism, to rein in the assailants.
Palestinians will hold demonstrations across the West Bank on Sunday. The fear is that if the peace talks make no progress, those demonstrations could produce yet more violence. Things are already volatile enough. This was Hebron. Some live ammunition was fired at rioters, an indication of how suddenly confrontations can get out of hand. Tim Hewitt, ITN, on the West Bank.
The son of Martin Luther King, the assassinated American civil rights leader, has met the man serving a life sentence for the murder. Dexter King spent an hour with James Earl Ray, then publicly backed Ray's claim that he's innocent. Joe Andrews reports.
James?
Face to face for the first time, Martin Luther King's son and the man jailed for killing his father.
Thank you for letting me come and impose on your time.
Dexter King was seven when the civil rights leader was shot down in a Memphis motel. Nearly 30 years on, he had just one question for James Earl Ray.
Did you kill my father?
No, I didn't, no. But there's, like I say, sometimes these questions are difficult to answer.
Now Martin Luther King's family accept that Earl Ray wasn't the killer.
I want you to know that I believe you and my family believes you.
And the King family have joined his campaign to prove his innocence and get his 99-year sentence repealed. Joe Andrews, ITN.
More than 20 Albanian refugees are missing, feared, drowned tonight after their boat collided with an Italian Navy ship trying to stop them entering Italian waters. It happened on the well-worn refugee route between Vlora and Brindisi. The Italians have sent 10 ships and a helicopter to search for survivors. Here, Sainsbury's have withdrawn thousands of packets of own brand cornflakes amid fears they could trigger an allergic reaction. They say some honey nut cornflakes have been found in their ordinary economy packets. Some Summerfield's Basics and Happy Shopper cornflakes have also been withdrawn. A Greek Cypriot appeared in court in Larnaca and pleaded not guilty to infecting his former British lover with AIDS. Pavlas Georgiou is said to have failed to tell Jeanette Pink he was HIV positive. She's been given 3 years to live. Football. England play their friendly against Mexico tomorrow at Wembley with Paul Ince as captain. The former Manchester United star, now with Inter Milan, is the third skipper under Glenn Hoddle's leadership. The previous two, Alan Shearer and Tony Adams, are injured. Here's Graham Miller.
Mexico trained at Wembley tonight ahead of tomorrow's friendly, their first visit since they lost to England's World Cup winning side in 1966. Paul Ince will lead out the school of 97, the first time he's had the job at home. He's Glenn Hoddle's third captain in five internationals and will now have to change the habit of a lifetime.
That's the problem I've just been saying before, like, you know, I was come out last with my shirt off, you know, and I don't like to put my shirt until I walk out the tunnel, which is something that I've done for quite a long while now. But I think on this occasion I'll have to make an exception and come out first, I think.
Liverpool's David James on the right is favourite to keep goal in a much altered side due to a stack of injuries. It's been the week of the English patient in Hollywood with all the crock players. It's been the same picture for the England football team. Graham Miller, ITN Sport, Wembley.
And that's the news tonight from all of us here at ITN. Good night.
Hello, good evening. We've been promising a good Easter for a week or more. It looks like we're going to get away with it too. Everything's set fair for lots of dry weather, some sunshine too across most of Britain, with the far north threatened by weather fronts, cloud and spots of rain at times. It's been windy today, that's spoilt things a little bit, this chilly northwesterly wind coming around the area of high pressure. But as the high moves further east and pushes the cold winds away, things will improve, I think, as we go through the weekend, even warm up a little bit, and certainly feel warmer without those chilly winds. But you can see the weather front close by too, even on Easter Day. It's still close to the north and west of Scotland. So if any part of Britain gets cloud and spots of rain, that's where it'll be. And that's how it is tonight too. The cloud is thicker across northwestern parts. Light rain and drizzle to come. But for the rest of Britain, certainly central and eastern areas, it's going to be dry and clear. A cold night, a widespread ground frost, with air temperatures down to within a degree or two of freezing. And then tomorrow, the thickest cloud and spots of rain in the far north will move away to the east, so most of Britain ends up dry and quite sunny too, though even over England and Wales, there's still a chance of a light passing shower, but that's all it'll be. It's essentially a dry, bright day. Now, it's going to be a little warmer tomorrow. The temperature's not a great deal different from those that we had today, but tomorrow's winds will be a lot lighter than we had today, especially in the south, and so temperatures of 14 will feel a lot warmer than they did today. 14 is around 57. And then for Easter Day and Holiday Monday, it's more of the same. The north and west having thicker cloud at times and light rain in places. But for the rest of us, the Easter weekend is going to stay basically dry with sunshine at times and lighter winds, so it will feel warmer. Good night.
Power Gen, generating electricity whatever the weather.
Meryl Streep and Dustin Hoffman are Kramer versus Kramer. After Central News.
What am I doing? I'm stuck in traffic. Changing gear. Pushing the clutch up and down. But now I'm using the new easy driving system with a normal 5-speed gearbox but no clutch pedal. And what's the only small car you can buy with the easy system?
The new Clio Zoom. Good thinking, Renault.
I went to Homebase for some new tools.
At Homebase this Easter weekend, you get a scratch card that could win you one of 5 Concorde flights to New York.
That's 2 screwdrivers, right, Mac?
Imagine. With over 10,000 prizes to be won, you could get more than you bargained for this Easter at Homebase.
Ladies and gentlemen, Britain's leading upholstery specialist has cut prices by 40% this Easter time.
There's 40% off this sofa. This leather settee is now only $4.98. And this loose cover one, only $5.98. You save 40% on a whole range of Easter time offers.
And whatever you choose, there's 5 years free credit with nothing to pay for the first year.
This Easter time only at DFS.
Wait for me!
Make a break for it with new Milky Way crispy rolls. Creamy white middle inside a crispy wafer covered in excellent Milky Way chocolate. You can even share one with your little sister. No, make a break for it with new Milky Way crispy rolls.
Alarm clock, shower, panty liner. A fresh feeling every day. But some women seem to keep it longer than others. One wears a conventional panty liner, the other wears All Days Duo Active. The dry weave top sheet absorbs moisture and locks it away in a deodorized core without perfume to help give you a fresh feeling all day long. With All Days Duo Active, you can feel the difference. All Days panty liners from Always. Feel fresher all day, every day.
Everyday brushing with Sensodyne F now helps fight gum disease and tooth decay, as well as fighting the pain of sensitivity. Sensodyne F.
If you're looking for a long, fun-filled day out, where you can get this close to the animals, head down to West Midland Safari Park. You won't have to splash out at only £4.50 per person. We believe it's really head and shoulders above the rest. The West Midland Safari Park on the A456 between Kidderminster and Bewdley.
These people
are doing something that has never been done in a TV commercial. They're praying. If you'd like to find out more about Christianity, why not try church this Easter?
The powerhouse sale must end soon. This twin-speed video recorder with Video Plus is now less than £130. So hurry while stocks last. Powerhouse, your local home appliance specialist.
You're with Central.
Good evening from Central. A man and a woman have been arrested by police investigating the murder of an 88-year-old spinster. Sarah Bateman had been strangled at her home in Halesowen with the wire from a net curtain. Detectives believe she may have been the victim of burglars posing as officials. Police say they want to trace a distinctive carriage clock which is missing from the house. A firm is counting the cost of one country's ban on the sweets it makes. The French have refused to take confectionery containing gelatine because of concerns about mad cow disease. Chambers Candy Company at Halesowen in the Black Country has built up worldwide export orders in its 6 years of operation. For 3 years, France has been its second biggest market. The firm's 24 employees produce £50,000 worth of sweets a month for the French market. But one of its most popular lines is made using gelatin, a beef product. The company realised the potential problem as soon as the British BSE crisis struck and switched to Brazilian gelatin. This is fine by 39 other countries worldwide, but a Ministry of Agriculture certificate and proof that the gelatin has been imported from South America hasn't satisfied the French.
We do a product known as Yoska's Gems that contains midget gems that are made with gelatin. We actually export to over 40 countries worldwide, and all our other customers are only too pleased to take our products. And in the UK as well.
Are you satisfied it's BSE free?
Yes, we are completely satisfied.
The French have now accepted an alternative product which doesn't contain any beef derivatives, but the problem has cost the company thousands.
We produce this product with the midget gems in it, and it has meant extra production problems and extra packaging to comply with the French authorities.
The annual £300,000 French order book may now be safe, but the company has asked for an official explanation of why British assurances of quality are not good enough for France. A house has been severely damaged by fire. It broke out in the roof of a terraced house in the Cowden area of Coventry. The blaze then spread to neighbouring homes. An elderly man was treated for the effects of smoke. Motorists heading north for the bank holiday found themselves in crawling traffic. There were delays on the M6 north of Birmingham between junctions 6 and 10 and problems on the M5 from junction 1 up to the M6. But motoring organisations say congestion wasn't anywhere near as bad as yesterday. Easter eggs with bite are being collected this weekend, but don't expect them to taste chocolatey.
These are the Easter eggs that the National Sea Life Centre in Birmingham is having to collect. They're the eggs of baby sharks and rays which are being strewn over the seabed, which are better known as mermaids' purses. To stop them becoming snacks for the grown-ups, they're being put in different tanks.
They actually wrap around the pieces of weed and the debris that we actually put into the display. So I've got to actually go down there and actually gently unwind them and then bring them up and put them into a nursery.
The centre already has a nursery of baby British sharks and rays hatched from eggs which came with the sea creatures when it opened last year. But its owners say it looks like there may well be an even bigger baby boom in the next 9 months, which means some youngsters may well be released into the sea.
Football, and tonight West Bromwich Albion lost 2-0 at Barnsley in Division 1. Both goals came in the first half. Neil Redfern got the first in the 34th minute. Then Neil Thompson secured Albion's fate with a penalty in the 40th. The result means Barnsley overtake Wolves and go second in the table, 2 points clear of Wolves, with a game in hand. There's been a new arrival at a safari park, but naming the little creature is proving somewhat difficult.
Sticking close to its mother, the newborn baby hippopotamus takes a sly look at its surroundings at the West Midlands Safari Park. It's the third calf for Big Gertie, who's just 6 years old.
We don't know what sex the little one is yet, because it was born underwater and she hasn't come out of water yet, so we really can't tell what's what, but we're just pleased that she's all doing well and in one piece.
Until they find out the sex, the park can't choose a name for the young hippo, but say, as it's born today, it's more than likely going to be girl or even boy Friday.
So that's all tonight. Good night.
Central Weather, sponsored by Stay Bright Windows, the clear choice in any weather.
Hello again. Well, things gradually get better and better through the rest of the holiday, although we do have a pattern of cold nights that go with the improved amounts of sunshine. Like tonight, it's clear enough to let temperatures get low enough for a ground frost, clear enough for comet watching though, and cold to start with tomorrow. But the sunny spells we'll see will soon have the temperatures on the up. 13 Celsius is a couple of degrees above the norm. It's a dry day too, and less breezy than today. More sunshine for Sunday, and even warmer sunshine, much how Monday will look to you. Enjoy it. That's all. Good night.
It's all over down under, so this Easter weekend it's off to Rio de Janeiro for the Brazilian Grand Prix. Murray Walker brings you live and exclusive coverage of the qualifying session on Saturday and the race on Sunday. The Brazilian Grand Prix, Saturday at 3:40 and Sunday at 4:20 on Central.
We are desperate women, Dolores.
Whoopi Goldberg stars in a movie premiere.
Somebody tell me why I'm dressed like this again.
The bottom line is, it's more valuable as a parking lot.
What?
What?
When? Now come on, if they're gonna close the school, let's go out with a bang.
This is you.
Oh, happy day.
And you're supposed to be a singer, girl.
Sister Act 2.
Let's party.
Back in the habit and loving it. Easter Sunday at 8 on Central.
On Central, our late movie, Kramer vs. Kramer.